Immune thrombocytopenic purpura is a condition when due to a break in immune system, organisms begin to produce immunoglobulin G antibodies against own platelets. In fact, antibodies are produced against glycoproteins that are present on a platelet surface, mostly to Gp2b3. As a result, immunoglobulin G antibodies bind to platelets and subsequently they undergo phagocytosis by macrophages that results in platelets destruction, and thereby thrombocytopenia develops. Thrombocytopenia affects primary hemostasis, and disruption of the primary hemostasis manifests with purpura. Important that immune thrombocytopenic purpura is the most common cause of thrombocytopenia in children and adults. Before the pathogenesis, we have to recall the major steps in hemostasis. So, if damage to endothelial cell occurs, endothelin that was contained inside the endothelial cell will be released into the bloodstream and will cause transient vasoconstriction. After vasoconstriction, organism has to immediately cover and repair the damaged area. In order to do this, endothelial cells release from viable polar bodies huge amount of von Willebrand factor. In the bloodstream, von Willebrand factor binds to subendothelial collagen under the disrupted endothelial cell. After that, platelets come to the site of injury, and by the specific receptor GP1b, they bind to von Willebrand factor, and exactly this simple step called platelets adhesion. After the adhesion, platelets become activated. In response to this, they undergo shape change that results in their degranulation. With degranulation, platelets release the content inside them, including the dense granules that contain ADP. ADP that is released into the blood acts on ADP receptor on platelets and activates it. Activation of ADP receptor forces platelets to transport Gp2b3 receptor to the surface, where Gp2b3 serves as binding site for fibrinogen. In addition to this, platelets from prostaglandins by COX enzyme begin to produce thromboxane A2, and the function of thromboxane A2 is to promote aggregation. When fibrinogen notice a Gp2b3 receptor on platelet surface, fibrinogen immediately binds to Gp2b3, and when another platelet comes to the site of injury, platelet immediately binds by Gp2b3 to fibrinogen, and this process is significantly accelerated by thromboxane A2. This binding occurs over and over again until platelet plaque will be formed, and exactly this gathering of platelets at the site of injury called aggregation, and aggregation results in formation of a platelet plaque. But platelet plaque is weak, and to stabilize it, to make it formidable, we have secondary hemostasis. The function of the secondary hemostasis is to make from weak platelet plaque a formidable structure that called thrombus, and the thing that makes this platelet plaque formidable is conversion of unstable fibrinogen into a stable fibrin. Secondary hemostasis is provided by coagulation factors that form coagulation cascade. The central factor of coagulation cascade is factor 10. The goal of both intrinsic and extrinsic coagulation pathways is to activate factor 10. Intrinsic pathway consists of factors from 12 to 8. Extrinsic pathway consists of just factor 7. Activation of factor 10 results in activation of factors 5, 2 and 1. Factor 2 called prothrombin that with activation becomes thrombin, and factor 1 called fibrinogen that with activation becomes fibrin. And exactly fibrin makes from platelet plaque a formidable thrombus. So secondary hemostasis converts platelet plaque into a thrombus. To assess the extrinsic pathway, we use prothrombin time and international normalized ratio. For assessment of intrinsic pathway, we use partial thromboplastin time. Now we have to discuss the key steps in pathogenesis. So, in the bloodstream, we have a lot of platelets that are circulating through the organism. And as we know, the function of platelets is to provide primary hemostasis. And to provide primary hemostasis, platelets have glycoprotein receptors on their surface, as Gp2b3 that provides platelets aggregation. Humoral immune defense in our organism is provided by plasma B cells. The function of plasma B cells is to produce antibodies against antigens. The function of B cells is regulated by T helpers. T T helpers basically tell B cells which cells are friends and which cells are their enemies. And obviously, in normal condition, T helpers recognize platelets as friends. But some viral infection or autoimmune disorder can affect the function of T cells. And in affected state, sometimes they cannot recognize which cells are friends and which cells are antigens. In this state, T cells force B cells to produce immunoglobulin G antibodies against platelets. And these antibodies are produced against GP2B3A receptor that is present on a platelet surface. Exactly this condition called immune break, antibodies against on cells called autoantibodies, and important that it's immunoglobulin G antibodies. These autoimmunoglobulin G antibodies bind to platelets, and in this state platelets circulate through the bloodstream until they reach spleen. In the spleen there are a lot of macrophages, and the specific feature of macrophages is that they very like immunoglobulins. They do not care about platelets, they like only immunoglobulins. And when platelets come into the spleen with binded immunoglobulins on them, splenic macrophages rapidly bind to immunoglobulin G on platelet surface, and by phagocytosis they take out platelets from the circulation and destroy them. As a result, the amount of platelets in the circulation decreases, so thrombocytopenia develops. Decrease in platelets count disrupt primary hemostasis, because without platelets, platelet plaque obviously cannot be formed. And disruption of primary hemostasis can be diagnosed with prolongation of the bleeding time. Also, disruption of primary hemostasis will manifest with typical symptoms as bleeding and purpura. Recall that any disruption of primary hemostasis manifests with typical so-called mucosal type of bleeding. First of all, they all have prolonged bleeding time. So in routine life, after cuts for example, bleeding lasts longer than normal. The major feature is mucous membrane bleeding. It's bleeding from GI tract, bleeding during menstruation. In addition to this, they have bleeding gums and nose bleeding, so-called epistaxis. Also, disruption of primary hemostasis causes microhemorrhages that on skin manifest with petechia purpura ecchymosis. But very important that decrease in platelets count do not affect secondary hemostasis. So in immune thrombocytopenic purpura, secondary hemostasis is not affected at all. And because of that, prothrombin time, international normalized ratio, and partial thromboplastin time will be completely normal. In response to decrease in platelets count, bone marrow begin to produce more platelets. As a result, on bone marrow biopsy, we can determine hyperproliferation of megakaryocytes. To explain this, we have to know that platelets are produced from stem cells, that then are differentiated into myeloid progenitor cells, and then undergo differentiation into megakaryocytes. Megakaryocytes are huge cells that cannot leave bone marrow, but exactly megakaryocytes produce platelets. So, in order to increase platelet count in peripheral circulation, bone marrow have to increase the amount of megakaryocytes in the bone marrow. So that's why on bone marrow biopsy we can see increase in quantity of megakaryocytes. The first treatment option are corticosteroids as prednisolone, methylprednisolone and dexamethasone. Corticosteroids, as we know, stimulate myelopoiesis and inhibit lymphopoiesis. So when we prescribe corticosteroids, they induce apoptosis of lymphocytes, so the amount of B lymphocytes decrease, with decrease in B lymphocytes, autoantibodies production decrease, and the lower is the amount of immunoglobulin G against platelets, the lower will be the rate of phagocytosis by macrophages, thereby the lower will be the platelet destruction, as a result the higher will be the platelet count. And also corticosteroids stimulate myelopoiesis that cause increase in platelet production. The next option is rituximab. Rituximab is anti-CD20 antibodies, and CD20 receptors are present exactly on B cells. So with injection of rituximab, rituximab targets B cells, and with binding, rituximab induces apoptosis. With decreasing amount of B cells, the production of immunoglobulin G against platelets decrease, thereby phagocytosis by macrophages decrease, As a result, platelet destruction decreases and the amount of platelets in the blood will increase. The next option is intravenous immunoglobulins. Intravenous immunoglobulins cause short-lived increase in platelets. The concept here is that with infusion of intravenous immunoglobulin G, basically we destruct macrophages from immunoglobulins that are binded to platelets. Because macrophages, they do not care about platelets, they like only immunoglobulins. So now instead of 10 immunoglobulins that are present on platelets, they will consume 5 immunoglobulins that were injected and 5 immunoglobulins on platelets. So we save 5 platelets from destruction by macrophages. As a result, they will remain in the circulation and this will cause increase in platelet count. The rescue option in case of refractory immune thrombocytopenic purpura is splenectomy, as we see spleen is the home of macrophages and thereby the site of platelet destruction. So by splenectomy, we eliminate the site of platelet destruction, and obviously with decrease in platelet destruction, platelet count will increase. And also we can prescribe thrombopoietin receptor agonists as althrombopag and romiplostim. Basically, by injection of thrombopoietin receptor agonists, we stimulate bone marrow to produce more megakaryocytes. And the higher will be the amount of megakaryocytes, the higher will be the platelet production, and thereby the higher will be the platelet count. We have to know that there are two forms of immune thrombocytopenic purpura. Acute form classically arises in children. Mostly in children, immune break is provoked by viral infection or immunization. And important that in this case, it's a self-limited disorder. Basically, platelet count normalize within a week or two after the presentation. Chronic form usually arises in adults. Chronic form can be subdivided into primary or secondary. Primary occurs due to unknown reason, but secondary typically caused by autoimmune disorder as systemic lupus erythematosus or chronic lymphocytic leukemia. If you like content, please press like and subscribe button. All the best!